Glenn Taylor, Senior Editor of Retail TouchPoints, and I'm here with Glenn Shoosmith, who is Founder and Chief Architect at Journey. First off, excellent name, by the way.
Thank you, Glenn. I'm getting that inside.
Well, first off, great to be here talking with you about Journey, which is a platform that what I've seen is very much a triple threat within the retail space, being able to cover appointment scheduling, in-store queuing, as well as even in-store events. Can you really elaborate here as far as how you managed to come to all these three parts of the retail spectrum here to really get your solution along?
Absolutely. So, I mean, like a lot of companies in our space, we started focusing on one initially. In our case, it was appointment booking. But actually, we realized the data sets, the customer experience, and everything all ties together really well. So it's a common one, you know, it's often in a telco store, they might have queuing and appointment booking, because actually they've got this issue where some people pre-book an appointment, then someone walks in, you need to manage both sides of that. And then actually, the events is a really interesting one. You know, we started out on a small business platform, and events are always a really key thing for a business to be able to offer. And it's actually a relatively new thing for the retail space to be able to do. What we're finding is retailers want to find a new way to engage the customer. So, you know, they're already coming in, or they're hopefully coming in, and they're trying to get them back into the store. One-to-one appointments are great for, like, considered purchases, but actually the events are a really powerful way of making use of the store footprint you've got and actually building brand with your customers. So, you know, some people are using events for, like, product launches, product showcases, some of them are using customer training, so, you know, customer education. And some of them are actually just opening up their spaces for other parties to use. Say, we've got this great space here, it's a big space, and let's be part of the community, which, you know, we're all involved.
And I feel like it's a great point bringing that all together, because it really does embody that modern store experience, which has to be integrated with the start of the process, which oftentimes can be online. And just seeing both of that really converge that way shows exactly why we're having a lot of these parts within retail that need to move in that direction. Really, what kind of pain points have you noticed, especially as companies try to, you know, converge in that way? What have you noticed within retailers, whether clients or companies you've seen around, that really put you guys in the direction to really want to cover those areas?
I think, you know, one of the pain points for a lot of people sort of buying online nowadays is an element of trust, right? It's very hard to say, you know, do you trust this review you've read? You know, do you trust the product is what it says it is? All the rest of it. And there's always that value of the physical store, right? So there's the physical store, you can go in and touch the product, you can go and see it, you can go and hold it. Is that pram you've looked at online solid? Does it, if you push it down the store, does it feel like it's going to fall apart?
Right.
And when you're buying stuff, you know, you can read a review, can you trust it? But if you go and talk to a consultant in the store, an expert in the store, that face-to-face eye-to-eye contact is hugely valuable to the consumer. And it builds a huge amount of trust between you and the customer, and it massively increases conversion, right? When you've got decreasing sales in stores, you know, when you say, here's a set of tools and technology, and here's a way of working that will increase the customer's interest in your brand and increase their basket size 3 to 10 times, it's like, why aren't you doing this?
And it's actually interesting, because at this conference, I noticed you had one of your big case studies come out working with Total Wine. Can you tell me a little more about really what you've done with them, where you feel like that's been something that has gotten both them improved on this end of things as well as really put you guys forward?
I think Total Wine is a fantastic business. You know, they exactly embody that sort of taking part of the community. And they use this for a whole suite of different things. And that's where the Journey platform is really powerful, because
right. It
isn't just a sort of single point solution. It's a whole suite of tools and technologies that can work well for different business use cases. So they do the one-to-one consultations,
right. You
know, wedding parties, it's, you know, and that's a great event where it's like, oh my goodness, how much wine do I need to buy? What kind of things do I buy? How much beer do I buy? What's my budget? You know, it's a very, and trust me, there's a lot of money and things to spend when you're getting married. And that's the thing where speaking to somebody, having a real consultation really helps. Then they do their events, their tastings, their wine tastings, their gin making classes. Again, people come in, you know, they can be a free event, right? But you come in for a gin making class, you're going to walk away and buy something. And I think the really interesting thing for them is they've started to do what I said, they've started to use their event spaces and say, well, look, does a local business want to have a meeting? Does a local group want to meet up there? Oh, and by the way, if you hold your business meetings there, we'll throw in a little wine tasting afterwards. And they say, no one ever walks out without having bought something. This is a fantastic way. And when you look at sort of modern community and how people are shifting work patterns, I think having like, oh, do you want to come and hold meetings in our stores? Because you'll buy something. And the final use case for them, I think, is a really interesting one, is it's actually on the supplier side. You know, what they use this for is for what they call their vendor tastings. So actually this is then connecting the suppliers with the customers. Because the suppliers want to be able to come into the store, book an end cap, book book a table somewhere and be able to demonstrate their product, and they want to go from store to store to store. So they use our platform to streamline all the painful internal administration of going, how do I book this over here? What store can I go to? What end caps and barrels and tables does the supplier need? And then they can just go around and give product demonstration. And that's fantastic for them to be able to streamline that process.
Gotcha. And really seeing these product demonstrations combine that with the in-store events, it really shows kind of that, that future of where we're seeing a lot of these successful stores, the ones that are really doing well, capturing consumers and making them, you know, want to come back, bringing retention involved here. Where do you feel like that says for, I guess, loyalty now going ahead as far as retention? Where do you feel like now, I guess, retailers have to go about prioritizing those initiatives to ensure that, hey, this is going to be something where they're not just coming here, but they're going to come back again and again and again?
I think, you know, Total Wines have this, and they talk about experiential retail. And they talk about the feeling you get as you get in the store and why you come in. And that's the thing that's going to focus more on. You know, back to the story about buying wine, right? You know, you can go and buy wine online. It might have a review. Do you trust the review? Mm. You go into store, you go into their section on Italian reds, and it's got a whole feeling of they're trying to recreate Tuscany in the store, and they've got the expert there, and they've got the woman who's been to Tuscany. And you can say, oh, you know, what kind of wines you like? I like this one. And so you're buying face-to-face, you're standing in a place that's giving you a great experience, and when you've bought that, you want to come back again. You know, you won't just switch online. You go, that was great, that was a great experience. I'm not only have I walked away purchasing, hopefully more than I originally planned to, but actually I really enjoyed the process of doing it as well, and I'll come back again. And that's exactly what retailers want.
And I love that Tuscany example just because it feels so authentic. And, you know, any time, even in many of the sessions that have gone on at NRF, I feel like you always hear about that authenticity and how retailers have to strive for that. And it's tremendous seeing that that's a perfect example of really why, if you're a consumer, you want to come back if you really want to see what's going on there and feel like you're part of it.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the, you know, if you just wander in the store and hope they're available, we face this inevitability. There will be less stores. You know, I think that's the thing that, you know, I talked in my presentation yesterday about the fact that the rise of the big box store was really a blip from the 80s that's actually going away and being replaced by the internet. And we're getting back to the real flagship store up front, the real white glove service where experience and the experience you get from being in the store is paramount. And with the inevitability of there being less stores, you're going to have to travel further to get one. It means when you get there, you want to make sure that the wine goes there. You want to, you don't want to find out he's off today. So that having that appointment, it's a really, really critical thing that says, you're not wasting my time. I know I'm going to get a great service when I get there. You're expecting me. You have the, you already have the light wines out or whatever it is. But that's a really critical part of changing the scape of retail.
Great. Well, yeah, on that, I guess one more question would just be really, what kind of do you expect now for 2020, just going ahead for a journey? Where do you feel like you guys are going to continue to move forward?
And that's a great question. That's a great question. I think for us, you know, we're trying to build a really open platform. For us, you know, the extensibility and adaptability of our platform is one of the absolute key things. You know, people don't expect software to be, as I said, it's not point solutions. It's not like it only does this narrow thing.
Right.
And I think we're increasingly finding customers that are asking, are demanding more of their software and demanding more of their technology. They say, this has to adapt to the way I work.
Right.
You know, it's no longer just an off-the-shelf plug it in. And I think one of our strengths is the ability to, you know, when you want to do that, when you want a turnkey solution that can start quickly, we can do that. But then we need to grow with as their changing use cases grow. So for us, we're pushing a lot more extensibility. We're also pushing a lot more reporting analytics.
Okay.
And I think data analytics are really, really key thing. People don't just want to see the appointments, they want to see the outcomes. They want to see what was the conversion rate, what was the NPS, what was, would they come again, would they recommend it? How much time is the staff? How busy are the staff? You know, how much time is free? How long do the customer have to wait to book an appointment? And all of that data becomes really useful to mine out and help adjust the store, particularly in terms of adjusting how many staff you've got at each store and making sure they're working the right shifts and working the right patterns to really optimize when the customer's going to come in.
Gotcha. Great. Well, I feel like, you know, given what you told me about Journey and really your work within the retail space, excellent just to see that multi-pronged solution there and how much it helps in so many different ways, both online and in the store, being able to bridge those gaps there. So, Glenn, on behalf of RTP, thank you so much, obviously, for taking the time here.
Pleasure to chat.
And absolutely, thanks everyone for tuning in.